It's time to put on our thinking caps and interpret the significance of what we've been exploring. Unless it explains, history is trivial. Did you find much this week that needs to be explained? In your explorations of Hellenistic science, you encountered different, sometimes contradictory, explanations. Interpretations have varied over time and continue to be disputed today. How can we take steps to ensure that our interpretations are warranted and not merely subjective speculations? How might we minimize our inherent human tendencies toward presentism and rational reconstruction? Many historians equate natural philosophy with the tradition that encompassed Aristotelian physics, using the terms physics and natural philosophy roughly interchangeably. It is usual to characterize early Greek science, from the pre-Socratics to Aristotle, as a golden age of physics or natural philosophy, despite the fact that early Greek physics was rarely quantitative in character. For the Hellenistic period, in contrast, the discoveries of mathematicians, including astronomers and geographers, seem to stand out more than those of the physicists. Would you agree that in the Hellenistic period, there was a general shift from physics or natural philosophy to a flowering of the mathematical sciences? Or might the pre-Socratic tradition in natural philosophy have resurfaced in other areas besides Aristotelian physics? In the Hellenistic period, do you think medicine was pursued on its own, independent of natural philosophy? Or were these areas of inquiry related? To what extent did the work of Hellenistic physicians, particularly Herophilus and Erisistratos, depend upon or contribute to natural philosophy? Discoveries in Hellenistic mathematics and astronomy were impressive, as was Hellenistic work in medicine. If there was a shift to an emphasis on mathematics, what might have caused or contributed to it? And why is an emphasis on mathematics significant? Earlier, with the help of Oscar Abo, we distinguished between several different approaches to ancient astronomy. The Mesopotamian tradition, as exemplified by Kadinu, offered quantitative predictions of the motions of the planets. In contrast, the early Greek tradition, as exemplified by Eudoxus, employed qualitative, geometrical models. The Hellenistic period witnessed a fusion or cross-fertilization between these two traditions. The result was a new approach to astronomy, epitomized in Hipparchus and Ptolemy, featuring both quantitative and qualitative approaches, resulting in geometrical models capable of accurate predictions. What does this account of Hellenistic astronomy suggest for the importance of cross-cultural communication in the history of science? That is Mesopotamian science as important as early Greek science for understanding Hellenistic science? To put it another way, is Kadinu as important as Eudoxus for understanding Hipparchus and Ptolemy? What is the most significant implication of all that you have learned this week? What is your interpretation?